this is Chaplain Ian Perry. I want to explain something about hoses. I started a DVD and I had to stop it because we had some problems because we were using garden hoses for aquaponics and there was some discussion that is carcinogenic and not. So I actually did some research and found out what the correct word is here. I'm just going to teach you a little bit about hoses and tubing and stuff. This is a typical 5 3/8, I believe, but it's typical garden hose used for non-potable water, meaning you don't drink from it. You can use it to water your lawn, but it's not for personal consumption, making of food. So when you're making an aquaponic system, do not use regular garden hose. There are different kinds of hoses you can use, and I will explain the benefits and the disadvantages of it. This is vinyl tubing. This is 59 cents a foot. It is rated for food. You'll find that in some of the soda machines and things like this. It's rated for food for your drinking. In aquaponics, it's good except it gets green algae in it very quickly, but it's very good to see what's going on in a teaching environment. If it was going to be completely dark, you wouldn't have to see it, but it's very palpable. It moves in different areas. You can use this. This is good because it's food service certified. The other kind of hose that we can have is PVC pipe. Now, there's different kinds of PVC pipe. Believe it or not, there is even a flexible PVC pipe, as you see here. This is a half inch. This, again, is rated for food and water. You can get this. This happens to be $2.49 a foot. It's a little more expensive because it bends. In some cases, when you're making something, it might be good if it's expensive to get little things to do corners. I like to use this sometimes. The other kind that we have, actually two more, we have this kind of tubing, which is a clear tubing. Again, this is not food service rated, but it's inexpensive. I don't recommend to use it because it hasn't been tested, but it is clear plastic. And the problem, again, like the other one, it would get algae, so I would stay away from that. Stay with the food service. And the last one is PVC piping that you do get in the store. This is 14 cents a foot, so we're going to use this in making it. It's the least expensive. Joints cost on average of up 25 cents to a dollar, depending on what you want to do with the joint to turn it. Again, this is half inch. You can get this at Home Depot. I'm going to include at the end of the website or in papers where you can get this. This is Aquato Ecosystems. They have a website. You can buy the flexible tubing, which is nice. Also, they also sell this at Aquatics Eco in Orlando. They sell this. But for right now, we're going to show you how to make a system here. It's going to be a continuous flow system as I did before, but we did something different. We, again, changed the tubing, so I'm going to be going over this step by step. I also am going to be telling you the prices of the things as we do it, and you can see it's not very expensive. It is the simplest system that you can make to feed. In fact, that is a system that we use here at the school now. We don't use anything else that you see here. This is what you use. Now, let's begin with this, talking about the equipment that we're going to be having. Let me move my chair out of the way. The first things that we need in aquaponics system is water, something to hold water. Now, I recommend this is $10, and you can get two of them, and they do work. You can get something bigger for $15, and you can go bigger and bigger. What I did is I went to the smallest one. Now, as you see, as you noted, it is elevated. Now, the first thing that we're going to do, if you just follow me with the camera, a simple concept. So if you decide to use something else, try to use it. It has a washer. This is the wall of whatever it is. You put this in like so, and it stays on there so you can stick up, hence bulkhead. These are $4.50. Okay. right there. Just lost my drink, by the way. See, I put this in, make sure I screw it in all the way. Look at that. It's not, we also make sure it's nice and straight. It's nice and secure. Now, if it leaks a little bit, don't worry because it's going into the pool. Now the bottom expander. This costs, I believe, 68 cents at Home Depot. I purchased it for that. I cut a piece of PVC for it. This is what it looks like. Just to see. As you can see, I put it right here. See, what I'm going to do here is putting it in. Now, I have the other bulkhead fitting. Put it right here. Have a grommet on the other side, so it's nice and waterproof. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm making sure that there, that's one. Now we're going to do it again. Okay. I cut two of these. Again, these were under, I believe, 25 cents. And of course, this was part of the 2 10-foot. As I stick it right here. Okay, the other one I stick right in here. Remember I said half inch? Look at that. When you put the air tube in, make sure it's all the way to the bottom. Okay, what I'm doing here is, if you notice, this goes in. If you could zoom in, Eric, I want the water to go in here. I want it straight. Now, remember this device that I put on here? It's going to go just like this. I put it right on here. Okay, let me show you a little closer. Alrighty. Let me give you a little closer view. As you can see, I have it into the pump. It goes straight here into this. Now, you can see why I like flexible tubing, because then I could really do a lot more, but this is inexpensive. See how it goes right into here? Look at it. This is the system. As you can see, all right.
Okay. pH, 2 for ammonia, 3 for nitrates. Those are 3 things you're going to worry about right now. As you get more advanced, we have classes that get more technical. But you're going to have to get this cycled. So you're going to run it like this, at least if you don't have any fish, and you can live in a city, you're going to have chlorine in your water. So you're going to run it for 4 or 5 days. Some people say a week. But after about 3 days, about a day, you can put some goldfish in it. And right now, I'm just putting the water in. Okay, we're going to cut the film for a second while it fills up.
Okay, my son's 10 years old. Eric, will you walk there? I just want you to get a visual. All right, we're going to go look at one right now that is actually working. Okay, here we are. Same system really being used. And this is what it looks like when it's all together. You can see it's not really that. That's what it looks like. I put all the parts in there. So it really doesn't take that much room for aquaponics system.